Today, you'll learn how to set up a free online store. So if you'd like a free e-commerce solution, a free alternative to WooCommerce or a free alternative to Shopify, if you're using something like Wix or Squarespace, you need like a free alternative to those. I think this is going to help a lot of people out. I'll also talk a little bit about free domain names too. So we're going to use free hosting and free payment processing, and we're going to do all this in this tutorial. So if that sounds interesting, then keep watching. For building a free website, I think one of the best options is just Google Sites. So you just head to sites.google.com and you can go to this template gallery where they've got a few pre-built sites, or you can start from a blank site. But I think starting with a template is quite quick and simple. I quite like this project one, but they've got quite a few to choose from. This is basically one I've set up already. This is the project example. They're very point and click. You just basically click, change your text. You can go ahead and change any images there just by clicking replace image, for example. And then they've got a few options for your navigation up here. You can change your menu systems, your colors, and then they've got a few different theming and color options over on the left. And you can just go ahead and insert more content as you need. They've got a few pre-built layouts, buttons and table of contents and things, but very simple to work with. I think if you can use like Microsoft Word or build a PowerPoint presentation, you can use this sort of software quite easily to build a free website. This is something I've set up already. So all I did to make this was I used one of these layout blocks with the image on the left, some text on the right, typed in a bit of a description and put an example hat that I might want to sell for our demo here. And then all I did was put a button in there. So just click the button, just type checkout or buy now or something like that. And we want to link that through to our Stripe checkout page. One little additional detail I did add here was this Stripe branding. So I'll share this in the description. You've got a safe and secure checkout trust badge here powered by Stripe, some credit card examples. Adding that in just adds a little bit of authenticity and trust to the user experience. So definitely add something like that in as well. All right, so now let's set up our checkout. So I'm going to use Stripe for this. This is my favorite free way of setting up a checkout. There's also PayPal, there's Square, there's Equid. There's other ways of doing this, but I like Stripe for this particular example. Once you've signed up and signed in, you can set up products here. I've already set up a cap here, but all you do is click add product and then you get this detail sort of thing. So you add in your product name, description, upload an image. We choose standard pricing and one-time fee. You can also do recurring fee as well. So you can do subscription products, which is kind of cool. And the other thing you can do is add additional prices. So if you want to add prices for different colors, or if you were doing different sizes, you could add different sizes as well. So you could add additional prices, but that's basically all you need to do. And then you save your product in. Then as we head back to our products, we can actually check this and we can generate a payment link here. So this is where it says create payment link. Just create that link. Now here, there's a few extra options. We can let the customers change the quantity so they can order multiples. We could use promo codes. We can collect addresses. And this is important for shipping. If you're doing a physical product, you want to do billing and shipping. You can select the countries that you're willing to ship to here. For example, you might just want to ship to the United States and Canada if that's where you are located in North America. But yeah, feel free to set this up as you want. And then go ahead and create that link. Now we can just copy that button with the button there. Head back to our page, edit our buy now button that I made earlier. Just put that link in the link field there, click update, and then we can go ahead and publish this page. And if you need that link again, you can always find it in the product there, and it's just under the view payment links there. And now when a customer comes to your store, if they click the buy now option there, it'll take them through to the Stripe checkout. They can fill in their details and go ahead and pay. So very nice little checkout, loads really fast and is very easy to use. This demo, I might just change that background there with the change image and just call it IdeaSpot Store Free Online Store Demo. So I think this demo page looks pretty okay. Now, one thing you'll notice here is that I'm using my own custom domain name to run this website. So by default, Google is just going to give you a Google Sites domain name to run your project. But I'll show you how I set up this custom domain name to make the site look a lot better in that address bar. So let's cover that step now. To add a custom domain, we go to settings there, and that is under custom domains. And then we click start setup, and we can buy one from Google here, but it's generally cheaper to get one from a third party, such as Namecheap has quite good deals on .coms, and GoDaddy has quite good deals on country specific things like Australian and UK domains. If you are desperate for something free, you can still get a free domain on freenom.com. Now, the only extensions that are free are just these few countries that allow free registration. So .tk, .ml, .ga, .cf, and .gq. These extensions will allow you to register a free domain. Doesn't matter where you're from, you can register a domain under these extensions. You won't get the full license, so if you do lose access, you will lose all your work, but this is a nice way to learn how to build and do all this without spending any money. But I do recommend, if you do spend any money at all, the first thing you should do is buy a .com, or if you want something cheap, .space or .site are only a couple dollars, but if you really want something free, this is still an option. All right, so let's use the third party option there, and I'm going to use newidea.site. So this is a domain I own from GoDaddy. So I'm going to verify my ownership here, and we basically have to copy this text record and put it in. So I'm using GoDaddy, but they've got a list here of all the possible domain hosts. So I'm going to find GoDaddy on that list. And then all I have to do is copy this text record and then go ahead and put that into our DNS management. So in GoDaddy's case, it looks like this. We go to our DNS manager. Yours will look similar if you're not with GoDaddy, but we add a text record here. So we're just going to paste that text in from Google, and then we're going to put at as the host and save that in. So that's all there is to it. We've got our text record all set up there. Now we head back to our domain verification here and we click verify. We should get that green tick of approval. So that's all done. All right, now that we've verified our domain, we can go back to custom domains and we can go to the third party domain again. We click next, pop that domain back in. And so now that it's verified, we've got that tick there. So we can proceed. We just have to add a CNAME entry and enter www and put this ghs.google.hosted into our DNS manager. So let's do that. I'm going to copy that. And then let's head back to our DNS manager. So we've got www, it's pointing to at the moment. We can edit that one, or you can just add a new CNAME record in if you don't have one. So I'm going to go ahead and just edit that one and put that in there, click save. So we should have a CNAME record for www, that's ghsgooglehosted.com. So that looks all good. We head back, we click done. We're going to get that connected domain there. So that looks all good. Just be patient, because this can take 15 to 30 minutes before this actually starts working. So just be aware of that as well. By default, this just uses www. So if you want the plain domain to work without www, you can add forwarding in here, just HTTPS, paste in our domain there, permanent 301, and save that in. So that looks all good. Everything will forward over. Namecheap's pretty similar. It's under advanced DNS. You add that redirect rule in there to forward everything over like that. And now if we head back, we can see this will load with or without the www like we can see here. So there we go. Both works just fine. All right, so you could use this kind of store to sell whatever you like, really. And like I said earlier, if you want to use PayPal or Equid or something other than Stripe, I've done that tutorial. I'll put that up here. Also, you could run this on WordPress. I've done plenty of WordPress tutorials as well. I'll put up a quick WordPress setup tutorial here if you want to use WordPress. And that's basically it. So if this was helpful, drop a comment, say thanks, or just hit that like button. But thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.